Yep.
We'll talk about that later.
Personally. Okay, I'm gonna get some all kind of shit, man. I'll be around some real good shit.
Hey, if you ain't got nothing, you got anything you want to read?
Yeah, scripture.
Here's John 10. It feels nasty out here too, though.
Don't it?
Oh, sticky as shit. Oh man, here comes your boy.
Here comes your boy. Got some demons on him. Get them scriptures.
Hey, we got a legion.
He's pissing in the bus stop.
He's gone already. He's gone off that loco, I bet.
He's over there pissing in the bus stop.
He's just laughing like he's possessed. He's just... Yes. Leak a camera shot of him. Oh, go ahead. Yeah, start reading John 10 and 1.
John 10 and 1. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that entereth not by the door into the sheepfold, but climbeth up some other way, the same as a thief and a robber. But he that entereth it by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him the porter...
Yeah, this is the door right here. It's right here. Keep going.
To him the porter openeth, and the sheep hear his voice. And he calleth his own sheep by name, and leadeth them out. And when he putteth forth his own sheep, go for them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. And the stranger will they not follow, but will flee from him.
Right, because we are here for the elect of the lost sheep of the house of Israel. So to hell with everybody else. Because when we speak, we the voice of the Lord, right? And he told us to go out and teach his gospel. So that's what we're doing. So if you don't understand our voice and take heed to our voice and what we're telling you, I guess you ain't one of those sheep. You're not part of the elect, and you're of no concern to us. And if you are part of the elect, you ain't gonna fall for none of this other bullshit being taught out in the world. You'll follow us, just as we follow the Lord, right? Now read that again.
A stranger will they not follow?
So yeah, we ain't gonna follow the voice of a stranger, somebody teaching a strange doctrine. We ain't gonna follow nobody talking about reptilians. Jesus Christ. Yeah, we ain't gonna follow nobody teaching the sweet Jesus.
Or somebody say, put that Bible away and let's talk.
Yeah, we ain't. If you ain't coming out to scripture, we ain't dealing with you, man. Because we're the apostles, we're the elect. You know what I'm saying? We're the hopeful elect.
That's what they hate, because you don't show them.
And we ain't following none of this other bullshit y'all there teaching, all these all bootleg Israelite groups. They ain't gonna listen to nothing you say. We know you're full of shit. Because you ain't is not the voice of the good shepherd. Y'all the voice of the devil. I'll keep going with that.
Well, they know not the voice of strangers. This parable spake back how shout out to them.
All cause like you got a lot of bootleg Israelite groups. Don't follow people like Nathan. You know, Nathaniel 7 at, what's that, IUIC? That, if you follow him, that means you're following the voice of the stranger. You're not of the elect. That's what that means. You're not part of the Lord's flock. Keep going. You're a spiritual goat. Keep going. You're a spiritual tare.
They understood not what things there were, which he spake unto them. Then said Yahushua unto them, again, verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. All that ever came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them.
Right, exactly, because we ain't following after no thieves and robbers. You don't see us up in one of these pork chop eating churches. We ain't out here at no Southern Baptist revival. You ain't gonna see us at with none of these little ghetto churches, man. We ain't following Rob Parsley. We ain't following T.D. Jakes or none of these other clowns. What's that? Reverend Billy Graham. We ain't down. He's a thief and a robber. Anybody who's not coming out teaching the name, Yahweh Shem, Yahweh Shai, teaching the truth the proper way like we teach it, you're a thief and a robber. Muslims, a thief and a robber. It's a Muslim who's walking up on them. That's thieves and robbers. You know, they some goddamn heathens. They ain't gonna follow the voice of the Lord because it's not for them.
I am the door, but me, by me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved.
But the Lord is the door. Yahweh Shai, the one they call Jesus, that's the door. That's how you get in. Oh, they got your boy.
He's waving to him.
It shall go in and out and find pasture.
Get them out. Pretending
to be good Samaritan. That's a fun.
They had some kind of secret deal going.
Probably getting in the head, probably blowing them. You know? Seriously, when did you ever see the cops protect and serve? Or serve and protect?
Never.
Never, never. So there's something going on with that.
Yeah, everybody I know, when a cop comes behind them, they get scared. They could be a perfect law-abiding citizen. A cop pulls up behind you when you're driving, you get scared.
Yeah,
we say fuck the police. Don't give a damn about the cops.
Most high don't respect them.
Yeah.
This bitch was bad as fuck.
Dude, that's that makeup. She packed that makeup.
Check your girl got a Sublime shirt on.
The old Sublime or the new one?
Well, that's the old one. That's some good music, man. You don't really hear people listening to good music no more. Everybody listening to some garbage. Everything's a bunch of degenerate shit. They got no kind of point to their lyrics.
Tree ain't doing his job.
Oh, I got that. You want this umbrella?
Fucking hate umbrellas.
Walking freely, man. No chains on. Without a slave master, like, we gonna have him, like, being the taskmaster. Ain't that the word?
Yeah.
Motherfucker, look over the slaves. Ham is vicious, man. That's a mean motherfucker.
Yeah, they are mean. And hey, Ishmael's mean, too.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, all them damn heathens are mean.
Yeah. He's on trouble, man. His women and the motherfucking men.
Yeah.
They in trouble.
Because in the kingdom of heaven, we gonna have all the women.
We're
going to run through all these heathen nations and taking their women. We'll leave a couple women for them.
Yeah, the
Roseanne
on them.
Look at your boy. He's pointing at the car.
Give my camera. Don't let him see you. He'll come over here.
It's my dude, man. I am so curious to know what man's he on.
He's on that Four Loko or something. Dude be gone. Remember last time we seen him up there pissing?
Yeah, okay. That's Tito shit at Four Loko.
Hey, I got another scripture talking about that door too. What's that one in Revelation? Revelation 3.
Door.
The Lord said, I am the door. He did knock it or something. You know. You gotta walk that straight gate.
It's difficult, man. It's a difficult way.
Yeah, you gotta come straight with it.
Yep. Which is difficult. It is difficult.
You know, to get to that door, you gotta walk that straight line. You know what I'm saying? It's not easy to get to that door. This is going nuts over here.
We've been sitting close for hours and just the grief that you see, that you go through. Wisdom, man, it just opens your eyes and many doors, like you said.
Oh yeah, just like Proverbs 1:7 says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom.
That's right. What's up? Wisdom, something like that.
Yeah. Oh, let me get this real quick.
They can't feel that. They can't relate to that. Because they don't understand.
Revelation 3 and 14. Actually, I'm going to start at,
My message, I hope he's different. I hope he's different.
See that camera can pick us up that far away? I'm going to read it. I just talk loud. Revelation 3 and 15. I know that works, that thou art neither cold nor hot. I would thou were cold or hot. So then, because thou art lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will spew thee out of my mouth. So yeah, so you're going to be doing this work. You can't be bullshitting with it. You going out teaching just once every 6 months. You know what I'm saying? You got to be in the spirit every day. The world should disgust you every day. When you're out here working with these people, when you see people eating swine's flesh and breaking the commandments, that should disgust you. If that doesn't bother you, that means you're not in the truth.
That's right.
Because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with goods and have need of nothing, and knowest not that thou art wretched and miserable and poor and blind and naked. I counsel thee to buy of me gold tried in the fire, that thou mayest be rich, and white raiment, that thou mayest be clothed, and that the shame of thy nakedness do not appear, and anoint thine eyes with eye salve, that thou mayest see. Because that's what this truth does. It opens your eyes up, just like he was just saying. Once you learn this truth, man, the Lord starts showing you all kind of shit. You start learning all kind of knowledge and wisdom.
Oh yeah.
This is the point I wanted to get.
You're literally becoming an outsider.
Yep. As many as I love, I rebuke and chasten.
Woo.
Be zealous, therefore, and repent. Oh, that's a good one.
Only you let them repent.
Right, because if you're in this truth doing the work, you're going to catch all kind of hell, man. People going to fuck with you. People going to come against you, talk shit to you, talk shit about you behind your back. Like, this motherfucker. This motherfucker's crazy. He ain't fucking right.
That motherfucker thinks he know everything.
Yeah. But it's the point I really wanted to get. Behold, that's Revelation 3 and 20. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him and he will... and we'll sup with him and he with me. Oh, that's my girl. To him that overcometh will I grant to sit with me on my throne, even as I also overcame and sat down with my Father in his throne.
That's right.
That's the point. So that's the kingdom of heaven. We're going to be sitting on the throne.
That's right. Ruling with a rod of iron.
But first you got to forsake this world.
Openly.
Openly, right, openly. You got to contend this world. What's that, 1 Corinthians? It says, where are the contenders of this world? All the disputers of this world. You're supposed to dispute this raggedy ass shit.
Undisputed heavyweight champions.
Got him.
Fucking fags like it too.
He's about pushing right to a car.
That'd be beautiful, bro. That straight up would be beautiful, man. Let me read this 1 Peter 4 and 30. For the time past of our life, many suffice us to have wrought the will of Gentiles when we walked in lasciviousness, lust, excess of wine, revelings, banquetings, and abominable idolatries, wherein they think it strange that we run not with them to the same excess of rioting, speaking evil of you.
That's what they do too, don't they?
Talking shit.
Those boys love to talk shit about you, man. Like it's that rioting.
Mm-hmm.
That's all these people, they're a bunch of rioters. They all wild and crazy. They're like savages.
You know, especially after a fucking game or some shit, man.
Fucking savage.
These motherfuckers flip out.
Goddamn football. It's that time of year, too.
Oh, God, don't remind me.
That first game come on a few days, though.
Shit, nah. Michigan start tonight. Jim Harbaugh.
Shit, man.
He start tonight. It's starting, man. And check it out, man. I know it's a major distraction going on.
this elite smart, man. They know when to do their thing, man. Because MotoGP, the motorcycle shit that's overseas that go all the nation to nation, country to country and shit, man, it's drawn down to the wire, man. It's like the two bad motherfuckers battling to it. Anyway, man, I forgot the point I was going to make, though. But it's just a distraction what Esau does. It's just a distraction, man.
Right now, the economy's collapsing. The economy's collapsing as we speak.
And nobody can talk
about it. And they worry about Ohio State's opening game. That's the number one thing on their plate.
Hey, or worried about Brady going to play that first game.
No, he's going to play now.
Yeah, you got CB. I knew that was going to happen.
Oh, yeah, see, a Brady football case, court case, matters more to people than them being spied on or getting shot up with vaccinations children getting molested in school. Or babies getting aborted, and then a doctor selling aborted baby parts. But they more worried about Tom Brady being able to throw a football and flat footballs with no air in them. That don't make no sense. But how stupid is that? People, they worried about flat football. Hearing as the world don't went to hell, all chaos about to break out, the last blood moon coming, CERN firing up the particle collider. Cops getting killed, race riots breaking out, and they worried about a goddamn flat football.
Right, my point was that the leagues are slick.
Yeah.
Because it's strange how everything seems to be more interesting in sports, man. They make it, they're fixing shit.
They fix it.
Just to make you keep watching, you know? They slick, man, but
you can't tell me that Super Bowl went fixed.
Oh, yeah, that's definitely.
That interception on the goal line.
Yeah, that's retarded.
Come on, man.
That's retarded.
Who throws the football on the goal line?
Somebody paid off.
With that beastin' ass running back. That doesn't make no sense.
Somebody paid off.
He got paid off.
I have no idea what you're talking about. Who's in this Super Bowl?
New England won it. Where they beat the Seahawks.
Oh, that's right.
That was some bullshit.
Yeah, that was crazy. Seattle Seahawks.
Hey, look, when the Lord gives it in the kingdom, we're going to be rounding these hoes up. Hey, before the kingdom, we're going to be rounding these hoes up. Look, when all this chaos breaks down out here, see, look, I'm a compassionate man. I'm compassionate. When these race riots break out and society collapses, if I see a little scraggly-ass, straggling-ass hoe, just all hungry, I'm going to take her in and I'm going to take a couple of men.
Come here!
Yeah, get your ass over here.
Let's go.
I'll protect you. You know what I'm saying?
Dude just threw his Four Loko. He is drinking Four Loko.
Only the Four Loko make you do that. And the cops will never fuck with you.
Nope. Vato's Loko.
He does not give a fuck.
Plus, he going to go to jail to hurt or something. They got to pay for that. He's gonna go to jail banging his head on the wall. They gotta pay for that.
Yep.
You know?
He will do that too.
Yep.
He'll probably piss all over the cops and everything. Yep. Take his shit in the back of the cruiser.
Yep. Yeah. That happens every fucking day. That happens every day, man.
For cops, no, but I don't want to clean shit out of my cruiser.
Throw up and vomit his shit.
Yeah.
It works sometimes.
You got something to bring up real quick?
Well, I was about to read Isaiah 4, but go ahead. Okay. But go ahead, well, you know, it don't matter.
I like Isaiah 4.
You know, these women don't like this scripture. You know, it's a controversial scripture. Isaiah 4:1. And in that day, seven women shall take hold of one man.
Yeah, that's in that day. In that day of darkness.
And gloominess.
In that day of gloominess, yeah.
In dark clouds.
Bro, these women are fair game. We're going to be like deer hunters.
Yeah.
Be out here with an orange vest snatching hoes up.
Who was that? Who was that? Today or yesterday, I don't know if it was ISIS, whatever, they snatched up 300 women, man. They got them all ready for prostitution.
Raping the hell out of them.
Yep. You know, women supposed to be so massive and strong and shit.
Why didn't they fend them
300
off?
300 of them.
It should only take two G.I. Janes to take them all out.
Right. They can't make a new movie to 300 bitches, you know? Man, 300 of them?
They put women in all the roles now. Now they got the women Ghostbusters.
Oh, yeah.
How stupid is that, man?
Yeah, they getting crazy, man, with this shit, man. They going crazy with this women shit.
They reversing the roles on you.
Hoes.
The woman's a new man.
Yep.
Female coach.
A masculine-looking bitch. Look like a fucking man.
Probably is.
That bitch thick, too, man. She thick, man. She played in the women's football league. The professional women's football league.
That's just like that Supreme Court decision saying,
Jenny Kravitz.
Got him.
Yeah, but that's just like the Supreme Court said a married man can marry a man. For thousands and thousands and thousands of years, marriage has always been a man and a woman, obviously. But now all of a sudden they're changing shit and telling you that's not true.
All of a sudden. Yeah.
All of a sudden now they're going to change shit on you.
Mm-hmm.
It's,
that's not a coincidence.
Everything's backwards, man.
That's not a coincidence. That's by design.
And then if you have a problem with it, oh, you're a homophobe. You're a bigot. You're a hypocrite. Yeah, you're that's hate speech. No, saying that faggots, two men can be married, that's hate speech. That's the most destructive thing in history. Is destroying the family and what a family is all about. I'm gonna say a man and a man, that's a husband and wife. What kind of fucking faggot shit is that? This is straight up country of faggots, man.
Sure the fuck is.
Watch, if we say anything bad about faggots, that's hate speech. You guys are speaking so much hate. That's why the Lord come back, man. He was me.
Don't teach hate at Ohio State.
I was just about to say that.
Oh, no,
that's funny. Some fags used to be picking us right over there. That was fine. Don't teach hate at Ohio State. That's funny.
Where did they go?
Yeah. Most high probably put them to death. Go for it. You know? I want some fine shit. Ooh, the stick is black thing?
No, no, hell no. That white thing.
Oh. I ain't see her. Esau.
Shit. Another one on the list. I got a long list of hoes that I got in my mind. they're right here.
We'll snatch them up.
Yeah, we're gonna go back to the caveman days, bro.
Esau was but kicking
there's,
it.
There's no such thing as caveman, obviously, except for Esau. The real caveman is Esau. But there's no such thing as a Neolithic age going back 200,000 years ago.
Right.
But just for the metaphor, we're going to do a caveman style. Hit a bitch upside the head, drag her by her hair.
This BBC got a documentary, man, on Tetra.
Oh, yeah?
They going off like a motherfucker, man. To them, man, it wasn't no moment, like, time of history like that, man.
They don't never tell you no good information about Petra.
Right.
They always talk about the Nabataeans. They don't ever want to mention Edom.
Right.
And that was what that's.
They say they were some civilized.
That
people.
Was way after Esau, you know.
No.
Because all that shit was built in Petra way before the Nabataeans got
that
there.
That shit is ancient, man.
It's real ancient.
Yeah.
Going back to the time of Jacob.
Yeah. Hey, that's why I can't wait till I make these signs. But anyway. You should see the Colosseum they carved out of rock there.
Oh, yeah.
You ever seen that? You seen the pictures?
I don't know
the Colosseum in Petra. It carved out, man, it's massive as fuck. And they say it's mind-boggling. It's mind, you know, Esau had some knowledge back then.
Yeah, everybody.
Because we taught him. You know, he knew how to do some shit, man.
All the most amazing structures is from the ancient world.
Oh, yeah. Still there.
Even the raggedy ass Hindus was building some shit.
Raggedy ass Hindus.
And what's some big ass temples down there?
Elon.
What's some big ass temples down in Cambodia? You know, them big ass Buddhist temples. Shit's massive.
Right.
The structures they built in the ancient world.
That shit is way up in
the middle. It far surpasses the beauty of the modern construction. You know what I'm saying? You look at the ancient structures, even the cathedrals and shit they built in Europe looks better than this shit. This shit is ugly. All this modern architecture is ugly.
That nigga had his rod out,
man. I hope he pisses on some of these fucking faggots.
You saw probably like.
You said he had his rod out?
Yeah. I just have him look over and he holding it.
And got him.
He so loves that, man. It's okay. Soon it's gonna be alright for that. It's already alright. So
walk by like nice shoes, instead of saying nice shoes, be like nice cock. That's what Esau would do.
That's where we headed. That's where the world headed. Nice cock.
Can I
see your asshole?
They got general neutral bathrooms now. In a lot of schools.
Yeah.
What kind of fucked up shit is that?
Okay.
Man, somebody needs to die for all this shit that's happening. That's why the scripture said
he just scared that bitch.
And what's that scripture? I'm gonna find it. It says we're gonna wash our feet in the blood of the wicked.
That's my nigga, man. I hope he bites somebody.
Don't get that on camera. That's fucking awful.
Well, is he still got his penis out?
Somebody might knock that dude out. I don't know. It seems like he got a cloud of protection on him. No matter what he does, nothing.
He just waved hi to the cops.
Well, is he walking down the street with his dick in his hand?
Commanded the children of Benjamin saying, go and lie in wait in the vineyard. See, behold, the daughters of Shiloh.
That's when Benjamin was about to get wiped out of the nation. Most of all the time.
Come out dancing and dances.
That's controversial too. This is real controversial. Some idiot on YouTube, I can't remember who it was, said that you can. This is only under emergencies that Most High does that. Was that Nate? Okay.
Yeah, it is a joke, man.
Then come ye out in the vineyards and catch you every man his wife of the children of Shiloh.
Hey, look, I'm sorry. Women are property, okay? They belong to a man. You can do whatever you want with your property. I mean, you gotta be nice to them, but they still, at the end of the day, they're property.
Like your cat or your dog.
The cat and dog is more loyal. Read that again.
And see, and behold, the daughters Shiloh come out to dance and dances. Then ye out of the vineyards and catch you every man his wife of the daughters of Shiloh.
It's Shiloh.
Shiloh. And go to the land of Benjamin. And it shall be their fathers or their brethren come out unto us to complain that we will say unto them, be favorable unto them for our sakes, because we reserve not to each man his wife in the Lord. But you did not give unto them at this time that you should be guilty.
Yeah, so they is snatching women up.
In time.
That's coming. It's coming, man. Hey, Paul, you see American Pharoah lose the other day? You ain't see it?
Is that a horse?
Yeah.
I knew it was racing.
That shit's fucking rigged, too.
How can that be rigged?
How can it be rigged?
You know, can't control them horses.
Amalek owned that horse. You should have seen their faces after the loss. They looked stupid.
Did they?
Yeah.
They probably had a lot of money. Yeah.
They looked stupid.
Hey, man, they got their way of rigging everything, trust me.
Oh, yeah, definitely, for real. Because he was guaranteed, he was odds on favor to win that race. Huge, you know,
like
gamblers.
5-1.
Yeah, it was 5-1.
It was probably 2-1.
Yeah, he was 5-1. Like it was 5-1. It was 5-1.
Where the fuck is my Python? Can't find my Python program. Oh, my fault. Go ahead.
Oh, yeah. Let me read that. Finish reading that.
That's some bullshit. Goddamn piece of shit phone. I gotta get a new phone. I got this ancient phone. Shit. Look at this little piece of shit. I've had this for like 6 years.
This is Isaiah 31:32-2. And a man shall be as an hiding place from the wind, and a covert from the tempest, as rivers of water in a dry place, as the shadow of a great rock in a weary land. So these bitches don't be down any motherfucking way.
That's what I was just saying too, because, like I said, we're compassionate people, man. Because we ain't gonna be like being Because people say, if you say you're going to snatch a bitch up, they think you're going to be mean to her and beat her up.
Oh,
and,
shit, I'm going to be a vicious, mean motherfucker.
No, what I'm saying is,
you know,
we're going to take care of women. You know what I'm saying? Because that's why the scripture said a man is going to be a hiding place. What does it say? Because they're going to be looking for us for protection, man.
I'll take it.
That's what I'm saying. In that day, she gonna need some protection.
Yeah, right. But I ain't gonna take her then.
Yeah.
I'm picky enough as it is.
And you. And on that day, there's gonna be no more women's liberation.
I'm gonna bring in some ugly ass bitch with a bad body. My bitch, all bitches I take ain't gonna be bad. Beautiful and with bodies. Shit. On my arm.
Need an umbrella?
Unless that bitch is got a. Unless she, you can read her. We gonna read spirits anyway. Unless she got a sincere spirit on her. You know? Yeah, that's what you was.
Damn,
my bad, but I ain't mean it.
Oh, you know, no,
that's,
yeah.
That's what you were saying, too.
Yeah, I'm saying.
Unless she has a sincere spirit on her.
What's your compassion on the hoe?
That's right. That's right. That's right. On that hoe.
Play will teach you how to be a real woman.
Show compassion on that hoe.
Hey, you might bring that. I got big ass trash bags.
Oh, fuck.
Here.
This one ain't no joke right here, boys.
Hey, you need one of these big-ass bags?
Yes, sir.
Here, dude. I got you. Just hold that. I got it. I'll put all your stuff in a bag.
This is just a sample of what's coming, man. People won't... That celebration is going to be pushed up out of the head.
Oh. This is me, sir.
Oh, not today.
Oh, not today.
Who's that, Urkel? Smell like swine flesh out here now. Smell that shit? Damn, Bible got soaked.
Yeah. We good.
Do the rain dance.
I remember that one day, me and my brother, we was kicking at the house. We was actually bumping loud as hell to rain dance on YouTube. It started raining, bro. I'm not saying that shit works. All I'm saying, we played it and it started raining.
It was probably forecast.
That's
Gadite. The real dance was the ghost dance. They did the ghost dance. They said they, that the white man created a law said that they outlawed the ghost dance because it put fear in the white man's heart.
Yeah.
And that's why they did it. They said they would play the ghost dance for days straight. They would take shifts dancing and singing.
Woo!
And it would just go continually.
And they was probably got that song probably had the Most High's name in it or something.
Probably did.
You know, there's some reason why they outlawed it.
They was doing that shit right here in Ohio. But they found all kind of ancient Hebrew artifacts right here in Ohio, written in the ancient Hebrew script, Paleo Hebrew, right here in Ohio. This shit ain't no joke. A goddamn monsoon out these motherfuckers. Well, you got, what's that? So you gotta learn how to dance in the rain. You can't wait for the sunlight. Why a day gloomy? It ain't gonna be a clear sunshiny day every day, you know. Oh, you got some people that'll never, if it starts raining, they out teaching the Bible, they'll wrap it up and go home. You know, sir, we'll stay out here like some soldiers.
There you go.
But I was looking for a scripture, I'm about to get it.
About to see a whole lot of wet t-shirts.
Hey, man.
From your girl,
Ann,
with the dog.
Uh-oh.
Oh, shit. Shingo.
Is it a chick or does she have a dick?
Oh.
Alright. You got something you want to bring out? Or?
I can't even focus in this rain.
Yeah, it's hard.
Oh, these wet titties popping around.
What's that scripture that said, where's that at? My phone ain't fucking working. Wash our feet in the blood of the wicked. It's in the book of Psalms. Oh, you know what? I got a freaking concordance in my book. I used to have that scripture memorized. Yeah, I got it. I bet I'll find it. Watch. I was gonna bet. I forgot I had this little mini concordance. They'll probably leave that scripture out though. You know, if you read that scripture at church, they'll be like, no. No, that is not the love of Jesus.
That's not what it means.
That's not what it means. Well, what does it mean? Can someone teach me? Ooh-wee. I bet it's not in here. Told you it's not in here. They got every other wash of it. Where's that scripture tell these hoes to wash their ass? Oh, see that catch? Boy, I'm
well, watching.
Wait.
Oh, you found it? Pretty good. Read that bad boy loud, too. Psalms 68:10. The righteous shall rejoice when he sees the vengeance.
Yeah, the righteous. Read that again. Listen up close.
The righteous shall rejoice when he sees the vengeance. He shall wash his feet in the blood of the wicked.
So we're going to wash our feet in the blood of the wicked. Starting with the goddamn Edomites, the rulers of the earth, the global elite, like all these banking families, all the these motherfucking Illuminati, government, fucking puppet master motherfuckers. We're going to wash our feet in their blood. When the Lord comes back, he's going to give us power. And we're just going to be running. We're going to run through these motherfuckers, man. We're running straight through them like David ran through a troop. Hey, read more than that. Read more than that. Yeah, right now we like lions trapped in that cave. But once that lion escapes, boys, it's a wrap. Go ahead.
So that man shall say, verily, there is a reward for the righteous.
There is a reward for the righteous. Best believe that. It ain't gonna be like this forever. Keep going.
Verily, he is a God that judges in the earth.
Yeah, and judgment's gonna come to this earth.
Where was that song, boy?
That dude looks hopeless right there.
Oh, fuck. Get him on camera. Most High got his ass. Well, it's just water with some acid rain, a little chemical rain, radiation, a little Fukushima radiation, but just water.
Revelation 22:12. And behold, I come quickly. My reward is with me.
What's that reward? Spiritual power. You know?
Yep.
A license to kill.
We're going to be like superheroes.
You know?
Oh, we ain't going to be like Batman. You know, Batman.
Oh, damn.
They can't kill nobody. Even though the Joker killed Robin, he still showed compassion on him.
That's some bitch shit.
That's some bitch shit.
That's some whole ass shit.
That's why you watch that one. Oh, go ahead. I ain't talking about goddamn Batman. I'm about to go into it. Hey, I like that shit. What's that Batman, the red hood? Yeah, I seen that ass.
Camel toe.
We told you, bro. We're making a list.
And we're reading it twice.
And they're going to walk around on display. It must be like, it's like window shopping.
Yep.
All these hoes walk down the street like they on that runway or something. Oh, fuck. fuck.
That's what they wanted. They want to be silly.
They it's on display like that.
You know what I'm saying?
You know, I hate that shit, man.
This shit is flooding.
I don't want to see women walk around showing all their skin.
Especially somebody's wife, man.
Right. And most of them hoes do got men.
99% of them.
My book bag is getting green.
You ain't got a bag for that?
Bags in
the middle. I ran out of bags.
Put it in with that bag.
Oh, yeah. Sure.
Try not to crush my hat.
I'll just put it on the house for a second. Actually, it feels better now it started raining. All that humidity and shit. This is kind of cool down. Every last woman, I mean, they all, I can see their butt cheeks, you name it, I can see it. Man, that's out of order, man. This country is fucked up, man. That shit should not be allowed. This is a nation of filth. A nation of degeneracy. Women should not be allowed to walk down the street wearing tight-ass black pants, little Daisy Duke shorts, where I can see her pussy lips and butt cheeks. That should be fucking illegal. These bitches are a bunch of goddamn hoes. I swear, man.
They want a compliment.
Oh, yeah. They say that when they see their best friend walk in the door. Oh, what's up, ho? What's up, bitch?
Oh, there goes my bitches.
Man, if you call them a ho, oh, shit, watch your ass.
Hold on, bitch. Let me show you the scriptures. Hold on, hold on.
I call my baby's mama a ho all the time. That's her, oh, that's her name. Bitch and ho. Fuck it. This is some faggot shit out here, man. Oh, got that motherfucker. He got hit with a tsunami.
Oh, I missed it. Oh.
Boy, you feel, oh, look at this big old fat bitch with a white shirt.
Yo,
you don't want to see her shirt get wet.
Oh,
that's nice. Look at the camera didn't get that one. Yeah, that's some, that's some swine's flesh arm.
They eat that ass out this time right there, man.
Oh, you know them fat bitches, they eat nothing but pork. They eat swine's flesh from sun up to sun down. Huh? Yeah. I bet it all got all kind of swine flesh up in that booty. I bet that ass was made straight out of bacon.
Yep.
Canadian bacon.
Yep.
Bob Evans.
Down on the farm.
Yep. That's nasty, man.
Fuck it, this stuff. We get the fish is using the fish with grease.
Yeah, it's some pork grease.
Then when you finish it, dry all up and turn all white.
Oh, oh, that's bad.
It's like yeast. It's like yeast. Well, it is yeast.
Yeah, they get a badass yeast in there.
Yeah. Yeah.
I get actual yeast in the pussy. How does that happen? I'm gonna have to research that.
A yeast infection.
I'm pretty ignorant. I need to research that.
And that shit stink too, man. A yeast infection.
I told you, I pussy I smelled last week.
Woo!
Bitch, the pussy stank so bad, she cleared out the entire gas station. A big ass store.
Right.
People were running for the hills.
Hey, me and catch yeast infections too. Me and catch them too.
Plus out here, they done made it so.
Huh? Like all the Chittenden and Neal.
What is it?
Neal Avenue and Chittenden.
Right here.
I thought Neal was that way.
Oh, there's chicken right there.
I don't know what's going on.
You said 11.
No, chicken is Neil.
Oh,
there might be a map at the bus station. Right here on the bus.
There's chicken. I think it might pop out on the other side of these days.
There ain't a map on this thing over here.
There might be.
Whatever you got, just read it.
If he says this 26 and 22, and harlot shall be accounted as spittle.
A harlot! Look, the Mormons ain't got no umbrellas.
Joseph Smith spirit ain't protecting them.
Right.
Yeah, he's supposed to pop out on the side of him like Obi-Wan Kenobi.
The spirit of Joseph Smith.
Like, this way, my brothers, follow me.
Right.
Yeah. Faggot ass Joseph Smith.
This way, my brother.
Man, I can't believe the Mormons got that many people in their church. They actually got multiple wives and everything. There's some dumbass hoes joining the Mormon church. You gotta be retarded, man. I mean, they're a bunch of weirdos.
Yeah, we used to read that all the time. Look at this shit.
Go back to that. What did you just read?
Read that again.
Oh, can you get that?
Look at your boy, look at your boy, look at your boy. Listen, look at that, That's my dude, man. That's my dude.
He causing havoc out here.
Yeah, I buy that motherfucker beer. Just for entertainment, I buy that motherfucker beer.
Because he causing stress in people's lives.
Yeah, yeah.
And they need to be stressed.
Yeah.
He bothering people.
He gripping the world.
He's just saying, fuck all y'all shit.
That's right. Hey, he gonna turn into a tailor when that time
comes. He is.
No.
Yes.
Watch.
Yeah, people like that's a spirit of vengeance.
Yep.
The Most High just use them as a vessel to fuck you up.
He gonna get him, man. I see it too.
Yep. He'll do it in the open, too. All these hoes, man. You know gaggle fuck a hoes. Look at all these hoes. Each one of them showing all everything. Look at it. They showing all of them. Look at all that leg. Hey, that should be illegal. Every last woman out here, you can see their fucking butt cheeks, their ass, and everything. Every last one of them.
I took this big Amazon over here. Look at
that. Yeah, that's a big Amazonian bitch for your ass.
I love them type of
hoes. You think you could bench press her?
That's impressive.
Yeah, because a woman, they like to be manhandled. Woman doesn't like, truly down deep in a woman's heart, she likes to be, that woman likes when you manhandle them.
Straight dominate.
You just dominate. They don't like little weak bitches, you know what I mean? They like to take advantage and manipulate the weak bitch. If you a type of dude that can dominate a woman, she'll give you all her money.
What? You saw that dumb bitch at the lottery for like so many millions.
And tell her husband.
You saw that guy.
Bro, how much?
Like millions. Like 3 million. Something like that.
Damn, he just went up in the restaurant with his dick out, came running out, putting his dick back in his pants.
Wow.
And he ain't going to jail.
Well, no. The Most High
is terrorizing people.
It's ruining their fucking day, too, man.
The Most High is crazy, man. Look, he ripped that shit open. Like you say, he went up at Eddie Jordan's, bro. He just ripped that door for like, motherfucker.
That's what's funny, man. They don't know the Most High like we don't, man. You know? They don't know him.
Run, Esau.
Yeah, because everybody thinks the Most High is all about love and happiness.
He's just a nice little fella.
The Most High, if you think, look at all these crazy people. Ain't none of them crazier than the Most High. Most High invented insanity.
He made all this, so
he made all of this, yeah. He did what?
Did it?
He pushed the Esau? And he ain't fucking with Jake, is he?
Nah,
he only fucks with Esau.
He punched somebody?
Nah, he pushed some dude. Pushed some Edomite. And that's the spirit the Lord put on. He won't fuck with Jake. Don't fuck with Esau. And that dude didn't know the difference between Jake and Esau, but he does in his spirit.
He knew Esau was a little bitch.
Yeah, he knew that Esau's a bitch. Yeah, that's what he knew. Look, get him out. They got the camera.
I think I had the security cover. Where'd your boy go?
That is security.
I'm trying to think of the time when the dude in the Bible was like, you motherfuckers out here front like they righteous ass people, and you know, righteous ass people, but drinking all underneath. You think the spirits gonna see it?
I lost my good Bible.
That's what these people think. They got the most high food. That's what they think. They think it's stupid, man.
Yeah, you gotta be retarded to think that. Yeah, just like that gay marriage shit, bro. They actually passed laws that say a faggot can marry a faggot.
You see why that woman up was denying the license to some faggots?
Right. They that woman down with it out in Kentucky. They actually locked this woman up. I'll give props to her for saying fuck those faggots.
She did a righteous thing.
That what she did was a righteous act.
And she's being persecuted.
And she's getting persecuted for it.
She should have read Revelation.
As people already know, though.
Revelation 2, get locked up in prison. That's
Right. Get locked up. They locked her ass up, didn't
they? Fear that, whatever.
I was about to say, but here it is. They locked it. Hey, give Leviticus 20 and 13. As we are. Now hold what you got. We're going to be back to that harbor. Yeah, because here it is, they locked that woman up for denying the marriage license to faggots. Well, here it is, the faggots are the ones who should have got arrested and actually put to death. Actually put to fucking death. Here it is, they committed a sin unto death, as the Bible calls it. As being a sodomite, a homosexual, is a sin unto death, which is punishable by death. By capital, what they call it, capital punishment. Instead, this world's so backwards, they punish the woman who was teaching people not to sin. What kind of sense is that? That don't make no goddamn sense.
They just tell you the world respects and who they don't respect.
Right. Because they ain't no respect for a faggot, man. A faggot's supposed to get put to death. Straight up. And we'll say it like it is. Hey, bring that out. The law.
Leviticus 20 and 13. If a man also lie with mankind, as he lieth with a woman, both of them have committed an abomination. They shall surely be put to death.
So that woman, she should have read that on national TV with all them news anchors out there. She should have hit him with that scripture. Because that's in the law. What book is that out of in the Bible? The book of what?
Leviticus.
The word Leviticus is the book of the law, okay? Because and who handled the law and taught the law was the Levites, the tribe of Levi. That's why that word law sounds so similar to lawyer, or you know, to the tribe of Levi. You know what I'm saying? You ever notice that? How the word law comes from the Hebrew word Levi. That's the law. It's right there. So, man, the Lord's gonna start putting all these faggots to death. Soon you're gonna have there's already a big outlash against homosexuals. Soon you're gonna start seeing all kind of homosexuals get put to death left and right. Like he said, the spirits of vengeance are gonna come out the woodwork.
Back in the day, I used to joke when they killed that one kid, Matthew Shepard.
Yeah.
Everybody's like,
oh, that's so sad.
Remember Matthew Shepard? He was like, back in the 90s, in fact, they got killed.
Yeah, I vaguely remember it. But just like everybody's starting to kill cops now.
You said Matthew Shepard?
And then we called a cow killings years ago. We said years ago, like, look, there's going to come a point in time when cops is going to start getting shot and killed on a daily basis.
Yeah.
And now what's happening? Cops is getting killed. It's already happening.
That's right.
Everyone, Chicago was just yesterday, wasn't it? Yeah, the day before?
Yeah, yeah. So the cops ain't feeling too easy right now. They very tense.
They didn't want to get shot and killed today.
Yeah. Dude, I can't keep up with it all.
My electric was off all day today, man.
I heard it on the news. Yeah.
I heard something about another one.
Which is funny. They're probably just getting ready to cut everybody's shit off.
That's going to happen, bro. Is the economic collapse is going down right now.
They probably created all these storms. Well, not probably.
That's how a plane, Black Movement, whatever, Black Lives Matter.
Black Movement shit happened.
They're gonna probably take away that freedom of speech. It's happening.
They've already taken away freedom of speech. You go to a lot of protests and they'll have section off free speech zones. So if you want to protest, you got to go to the free speech zone. What kind of sense does that make, man?
That's coming for sure.
Oh, ain't no goddamn sense.
That's coming, man.
Well, the free speech is already done away with. Be a famous person. Look, just like what happened to the new CEO of Mozilla, the people who make the Firefox web browser. You remember that, like a year ago, when he became the head of Mozilla, they found out that he supported anti-gay marriage candidates, and he pretty much got fired. He got pushed out. He resigned, but they pushed him out because he wasn't down with the faggot agenda. So there is no free speech. The only reason we can speak freely is because the Lord is dealing with us. And there's nothing they can do to stop us. We got a blanket over us, like a force field, like a dome. We under that dome, Pastor. Yeah, we under the wings of an angel. You know what I'm saying? What's that? The angel of compassion is about? Why we out here teaching? I don't even pay attention. I should. Especially when it gets light laid out, you can see this area.
Hell yeah. We ain't got Sue Storm with invisible shield around us.
Nope.
Amos 8.
Bitch be getting a headache when she pulled up the 14. What kind of spiritual power she got? Damn.
This is that right there.
another t-shirt contest.
Y'all want to show it off like that? Shit. That's what I'm saying, bro. See, that causes all kind of sin and filth when bitches walk around. Look, you can see the bitches, the court, they're short, they cut, they're wearing them cut off shorts, they cut off so short that you can see their pockets.
That's right.
And you can see their butt cheeks. You just want to go up and squeeze their butt cheeks and shit. I mean, because that's just a natural instinct when you see an ass like that. Right? People are like, oh, you're not a man in the Lord talking like that. Well, I'm saying that we shouldn't be able to see the ass. So I'm not tempted. The ass needs to be covered. The titties need to be covered. What's so hard to understand about that? That doesn't mean I like ass and titties. Or don't like them. I love them. See, look. You guys.
It's the worst since ever been since we ever been out here.
The rain? Mm-hmm.
We had bad rain days.
You got a damn puddle
came down the bag.
This is a bad storm, man.
Hey, prophets of doom. We out here prophesying in doom. This is nice, man.
I think it feels good out here.
Yeah, it feels nice.
It feels a lot better than what it did. It's just water. We out here with the rivers of living water.
There's someone threw a banana peel.
I just can't let my Bible get flooded, man.
Yeah, my Bible's starting
to
get...
Talk about that tablet. This Bible's going to me.
I know you, that Bible, you had that for a minute.
You know what I'm saying?
Man, that bitchy shirt is completely soaked. Holy shit.
Yeah, it rain ain't gonna kill. Good thing with that. Here, go ahead.
Almost. Hey.
I'm feeling left out. Actually, fuck it. I'm
all right. I was sin offended in the land.
Hey, let's scoot up something. Read that again. Did that
we
rain?
All scoot down this way.
Why is that?
I'm trying to cover the
bag.
Oh,
yeah.
Too.
Oh, you're good. Go ahead. Just read a little louder because it's real loud. Tartar, you know what I mean? All that rain and shit. Just try to read loud.
Behold, the days come, said the Lord God, that I will send a famine in the land. Not a famine of bread, nor a thirst for water, but of hearing the word of the Lord. They shall wander from sea to sea, from the north even to the east. They shall run to and fro.
That shit's coming out even harder.
Walking back and forth with a stupid ass look on their faces, looking for the word. When we out here trying to give them the word, trying to share the word with them, but ain't nobody trying. There's no even curiosity out here. These motherfuckers not even curious to hear the word.
And it could be, it's not because it's raining.
Right, right.
We've had people that was curious. We've had people that was curious and just stood right in that rain and got drenched while they listened.
So when that time comes, that famine of the word, man, that motherfucker gonna be, they're gonna die of thirst. That thirst. You know? Because you know, a spiritual thirst, that's some heavy shit. When your spirit is heavy, you're bothered by shit.
You don't know what to do.
Yeah, right. That's heavy, man.
You're seeking for answers.
That's heavy, man.
That's why they didn't talk about that spiritual thirst. That's why the Lord said, my people, they like broken cisterns that can hold no water. you know what I'm saying? It's like, you know, you ever have a glass with a hole in the side of it? Or a cup?
Yep.
You get a cup from Burger King, got a hole in it, shit just squirting out. You'd be mad as hell. That's why you read the book of John, the fourth chapter. Hey, let me get something real quick. You see, he's talking about that water.
That's amazing. Two of them, look at that.
What's that?
Two of them ginger.
I'll take a ugly ginger. That's rare. John 4:22. Ye worship, ye know not what. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. Also, a lot of people, they claim they believe in the Bible, but do they really believe in it? Hell no. They don't know what's going on. They don't know nothing about the Bible. They don't even know what an Israelite is. But that hour cometh now when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and truth, for the Father seeketh such to worship him. Actually, that's not even what I was looking for. I was looking for John 7, my fault.
Right. Oh, damn. You just got soaked.
Oh, you got the tsunami?
Watch, he about to get it again.
Oh, this is what I want to read. John 7:38. He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. That's that thirst. Oh, you know what? I did want to get that John 4. Because remember, because I was just reading it. I skipped the good part. When the woman at the well, my Bible's getting soaked. Because what? Yeah, it was St. John. But when that woman at the well, she was asking for a drink of water out of the well, right? And he's like, whoever follows me shall never thirst. Or something like that,
that's right?
There
you go.
But my Bible's getting soaked.
That's that spiritual thirst or something like that.
Yeah. I'll see if I can get it without ruining my Bible.
This is what you controls the whole change. When a woman lays down, it's like it's a thing you get on.
Yep. And watch this.
They can be very weight bad or not, man. But when they lay down, it looks similar. They look back to a lady.
Let me read this real quick. St. John 4:9. Then saith the woman of Samaria unto him, how is it that thou, being a Jew, ask a drink of me, which am a woman of Samaria? For the Jews have no dealings with the Samaritans. And Yahushua answered and said unto her, if thou knowest the gift of God, and who it is that saith to thee, give me to drink, then thou would have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water. Then the woman saith unto him, sir, thou hast nothing to draw with. He was hitting her with a parable. She couldn't even get the parable, because she's a heathen. And the woman saith unto him, sir, thou hast nothing to draw with. The well is deep. From whence then hast thou living water? She's so stupid. The woman. Just women in general are stupid, especially heathen women.
Wouldn't let that stag water, he's a stag.
Oh, that's not good.
Still. Without motion or...
Stag, that means death.
Lifeless.
The word stag ain't gonna come back to the word death. Stag,
snake. Look at that bitch running barefooted.
Probably has some heels. Now let's get this. John 4:12. Art thou greater than our father Jacob? You got that? Art thou greater than our father Jacob, which gave us the well and drank there of himself and his children and his cattle? And Yahushua answered and said unto her, whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again. Talking about the actual water in the well. Whosoever drinketh this water shall thirst again. But whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst, but the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life. Oh, look. Well, that's the point. That's the point. My Bible's getting messed up, man. We got to start quoting. Actually, let's get back to the parable. Are you about to get something?
What you doing, bro?
Psalm 78.
That one right there, boy.
Damn. Well, we're going to have a field day.
Look at this guy.
It's going to start 78-1, you know?
78-1.
Psalm 78-1. Give ear, O my people, to my law. Incline your ears to the words of my mouth.
Yeah, incline your ears to the words of the mouth of the Lord, to the Bible, to the words of the Lord. He going?
I will open my mouth in a parable and will utter dark sayings of old.
Read that again.
I will open my mouth in a parable and will utter dark sayings of old.
He going?
Which we have heard and known, and our fathers have told us. We will not hide them from their children. Join.
Oh, I'm saying, because we out here speaking parables. We speaking dark sayings, which were of old. You know what I'm saying? People always say, why you got that old-ass book? We out here speaking dark sayings, which were of old. Y'all don't know nothing about that. That's why y'all can't understand what that living water is. Because like he said, y'all got no living water. You got stagnant water with goddamn mosquitoes all up in it, all festering up in it. You have brain-eating amoebas, mosquitoes. What else is up in there?
All kinds of those, man.
Oh, parasites and bacteria. Stagnant water is what y'all got. Well, that's what I'm talking about, the world. Not the brothers who believe, obviously. Go ahead. Read that one more time. I just like the way that sounds, man.
I will open my mouth.
Yeah.
In a parable, I will utter dark sayings of old, which we have heard and known, and our fathers have told us.
Our fathers have told us. And this is our fathers right here. Who wrote the Bible? That's our forefathers. Our actual living, breathing, walking, talking forefathers.
Yep.
Who were here before us.
That's right.
And that's why they wrote this and left this for us. so we can learn about them old dark sayings and parables and learn about the laws.
We will not hide them from their children, showing to the generations to come the praises of the Lord and his strength and his wonderful works that he hath done.
Yeah, the Lord's works is wonderful.
For he hath established a testimony in Jacob and appointed a law in Israel, not and all nations.
Not exactly. I was about to say the exact same thing. Not all nations.
I had to get that one out.
Yeah. Because he said Jacob, Israel. He didn't say Ham and Esau and Ishmael. He said Israel, Jacob.
Moab.
There ain't no Moab over here. Moab is just for sucky, sucky, fucky, fucky. Love me a long time. And most of them bitches be Jakes. Go ahead.
For he established a testimony in Jacob and appointed a law in Israel, which he have commanded our fathers that they should make them known to their children.
Right. So you people are like, why are you using that old book? Well, that was the commanded to us to teach our children, and for our children to teach their children, and their children to teach their children. But now ain't nobody teaching the laws of the Lord now. You got faggots getting married. And all this other filth. Bitches walk around half naked. You can't concentrate because every last woman's butt cheeks are showing. Their titties are showing.
Ain't nothing worse than a bitch with multiple niggas, man.
There's no way.
Ain't nothing worse than that, man.
That's encouraged out here. Adultery is encouraged in America. A sexually promiscuous lifestyle is encouraged. I mean, that's why there's so many clinics. Every neighborhood got a clinic. Why every neighborhood got a clinic? Because all these hoes got diseases. All these dudes too, they got, you know, you don't want to know what's wrong with them. And what's going on with their health. They got so many STDs that ain't funny. These are unspeakable STDs. What they do to your body is unspeakable. They'll gross you out. Like he was talking about them yeast infections. You be pissing, maybe not me, but these faggots pissing pus, pissing blood. Yeah, they make you go blind. They make you go crazy. They say that syphilis get up in your brain and everything. Otherwise, it's just...
That the generation to come might know them, even the children which shall be born, who shall arise and declare them to their children, that they might set their hope in the Most High, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, and not forget the works of the power, but keep his commandments.
Yeah, he's supposed to keep the Lord's commandments. One of the commandments, don't be a fucking faggot. One of the commandments is don't eat swine.
Why can't we have sex with men?
Oh, shit.
Why can't I have sex with men?
You like to play in human feces?
Nothing but a
you love it, though. So you're a shit eater. Shut up, dude. Yeah, Tracy.
Yes, we are. Faggot.
That's amazing.
Yo, look, I asked him if he likes to play with feces. Yeah, you see his head turn, and he didn't know what to say then, did he?
His boyfriend was like, I love him.
Because they probably into that scat sex,
he's
too.
He's offended by the Lord's commandment. He's offended.
And that's why you gotta come out here and get in people's faces.
Goddamn faggots.
You get in a faggot's face and tell them that the Lord is gonna kill all you faggots.
Fucking sodomites.
Sodomite. And you gotta come out here in all boldness. You ain't supposed to be afraid of faggots.
Fucking sodomites.
People just put up with this shit, man. And like you said, it's a goddamn shame that, like, of all these people denying marriage, the only person that was denying the marriage license to faggots was a woman. A goddamn woman.
A woman.
A
dumbass woman.
Where's all the men at to work at all them places? How come they not doing that? That's a goddamn shame, man.
We done seen it all.
Oh, you did? No, don't say that.
Oh, God, you know, don't say that.
Don't say that.
I'm just 7 foot.
Is that a dude? They're probably both athletes. He probably fucking plays center for Ohio State. I don't know, they got bitches bigger than her. She might just be a forward. She's a forward. Man, it's rainy. It's not no joke, boy. Now come to win. It's going to say, fuck your umbrella. You know, it's like your umbrella just turns inside out and shit.
Yeah, that happened to your
umbrella. It happened to my giant umbrella.
Ooh, okay.
Yeah, I see that lightning too, boy. That's a good day to be out here, man. It's really good. No, the Lord's going to destroy America.
What did he say? I can't have sex with men. What did he say?
Yeah, that's what he said. He said, you're telling me I can't have sex with men.
Oh, my
God. He was genuinely upset. He said he was born like that. If you was born of a woman, you'd have a vagina.
And the other one, Clever said, slavery's in the Bible. Why can't there be fags? Why can't the have sex with men? Said he was saying it was.
Oh, is that what he said? Oh, yeah. Well, slavery is in the Bible.
That's right.
And all these homosexual Edomites are born into slavery. So he made a good point. You're damn right. Slavery is not in the Bible. Nowhere does it say the word slave. It says servants. They're going to be our servants.
Ministering to us.
Yeah, they're going to minister unto us. They're going to bow with their feet into the dirt. They're going to lick the dust of our feet. That's what's going to happen. I love coming out here teaching the Bible to these, talking shit to these fucking faggots, man.
That fucked his head up. He's fucked up from that one.
Because you be vexing the spirit. You see all this homosexual agendas being pushed on TV and everywhere. But we actually get to come out here and curse these faggots out right to their face. And let them know that their time is short. That's why, if you believe in this truth, you got to do the work. If you're truly upset with faggots, you got to come out here and cuss these motherfuckers out, man.
Triumphing of the wicked is just for a moment.
Right. It's just for a moment. You're supposed to be out here disputing this world, man. Just like the book of Corinthians says, where are the disputers of this world? They gonna say Jesus. You know that shit? Hella, hella, hella.
Oh, shit.
Because these dumbass women, man, they'll never get the truth. Don't waste your time teaching women. If you ever see us teaching women, that's just because it might make a good video. Because we already know they're not going to get it.
Not a market bitch, too.
Yeah, if you're trying to get some pussy, definitely don't try to teach them.
Nah, that's an anti-pussy.
You got to get marked, too.
Yeah, you got to get marked. You might have a sincere one here every once in a blue moon. We'll talk to a sincere woman. But they're still not going to be able to get deep into the truth and knowledge. They might have great faith.
As you bring up astrology, they're going to be all up there.
Right. I mean, you know, some of these women, they got faith. But they're not going to have that knowledge.
They got a short attention span. You just change the subject and they'll go on with you. Like, they forget what you was talking about. Like,
totally.
Yeah.
What you do teaching the Bible? Oh, you know, that game's on tonight. They'll be like, oh, yeah, the game.
Because most women, actually 99% of them, their mind is not built for knowledge. Their mind is not built for deep mysteries and dark sayings and parables. Their mind is not made for that. Their mind was created to be a helpmeet to the man. And that's it.
But there's nothing complicated about that.
There's not. I mean, all the books of the Bible are named after men. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Isaiah, Jeremiah, Haggai, Zechariah, Zephaniah. They're all men. Every last one of them. All except
for Ruth.
Yeah. But that's a story about Ruth.
Right. Here you go. This is Job 39:17. Because the most time
one more. I gotta correct myself. You got the book of Esther too. And you do got the book of Susanna. But I bet you that wasn't written by Susanna. Because Susanna was an example of a righteous woman. Just like Judas was an example of a righteous woman. You ain't gonna find a whole lot of Judas and Susannas out here. Okay? It ain't happening.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
Job 39 and 17. Because the Most High hath deprived her of wisdom, neither hath he imparted to her understanding.
Yeah, because these women have no knowledge and understanding. They're gone. I mean, the men are gone too, but the women...
It's their genetic makeup.
Yeah, they're not built for it. It's not their job.
Proverbs 8 and 4. Unto you, O men, I call, and my voice is to the sons of men.
To the sons of men, not to the daughters of women. It's the sons of men, not the, you know what I mean? Oh, hold on, I got it. Let's see, we're talking about women. Let's get the proper order. This never gets old. Now I was gonna get Peter.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Order.
By the way, like Mary Poppins.
That brain was something else.
Oh, it ain't done yet.
It looked great. It's pretty angry up there, don't it? My revelation got messed up. Alright, I'm almost got it. 1 Peter 3 and 1. Likewise, ye wives, being subject... Listen! Likewise, ye wives, be in subjection to your own husband, that if any obey not the word, they also may be without the word, be won by the conversation of the wives. Conversation of the wives, all these hoes do is gossip, talk shit about their husbands behind their backs. They tell their girlfriends, you need to leave that motherfucker, he ain't no good. You need to leave that motherfucker. Hey, these women are a bunch of hoes and bitches, man. They are trifling as hell. Just a bunch of nasty, filthy, disgusting whores.
What's up, bro? Okay.
Let me read more. I only finished this up. While they behold your chaste conversation coupled with fear, whose adorning, let it not be that outward adorning.